Manufacturing technology is progressing really rapidly as it becomes more and more digital. So there are websites like Thingiverse or GrabCAD where there's a huge amount of data, but it's relatively low quality because anybody can upload a model. So what we're trying to do is better understand the relationship between the characteristics of data sets and the expected accuracy of machine learning models trained on them. There's a lot of inequity in terms of not only who has access to data, but who has the ability to turn that data into knowledge. So for a relatively small manufacturing company to start doing machine learning, they either have to send one of their employees back to school, hire a consultant, or bring on somebody new full-time. So this research is really for them. We want to support small manufacturing enterprises and small companies in learning the true value that's in their data so they can use it to better produce and better compete in the marketplace. So recently we worked with a company called Rexnord, which is a traditional manufacturer, to better understand the value in their data and to help them begin the first step along their journey to using additive manufacturing. So recently my team started looking at some of the same issues of how to understand and manage data in the construction industry. So in a new project that's funded by the Construction Industry Institute, we are trying to understand what the new opportunities in construction are for using artificial intelligence, machine learning, and data analytics to support something called advanced work packaging, which is an emerging best practice in construction. The big takeaway is that we're trying to understand what the connection is between characteristics of data and what the accuracy is you can expect of the eventual machine learning model. And we're doing that to help people better understand the value that's inherent in their data without having to put in a lot of effort up front.